Good morning, guys. Good morning and good evening, one and all. So today we will see so migration part. Okay, these are the things we have available to migrate. Okay, our on-premise data or database to Azure of IaaS model or PaaS model. So yeah, the difficult, it's not a difficult task, okay. Migration is very easy. So yeah, on-premise to Azure database migration is a little bit tough. Little bit tough is nothing but so we have to migrate the data using scripts and we need schema plus data scripts. We need to migrate. Like suppose, we have an on-premise database, right? For IaaS model database, what you can do, just you can take the .bak backup, okay? And you can restore directly. Okay, in IaaS model, you can restore just by taking the .bak. Everything will be supported, okay? So for manager instance, just same .bak backup, you can keep in online, like some storage account you can keep here, and you can restore this one into manager instance. Okay, so these are all very easy. Just take the backup and you can restore over here, IaaS model manager instance. So the other thing is, okay, Azure database. So Azure database, you cannot directly migrate .bak. So .bak will contain MDF, LDF, right? So you cannot migrate like directly. So instead of, okay, how we gonna do is, first generate the schema. Schema plus data, okay? Both you need to generate the script. Either tool or manually, anything, okay? This schema data, same thing will be run in Azure database. This way we can migrate. Okay, any tool which are available in the market to migrate on-premise database to Azure. So inside, how they are following is, they are just taking the schema script out and data script out, and they are running into the Azure database. Simple thing. Okay. Even we can migrate the database manually also. Just right click, generate the script and deploy into the Azure. Next, data, right? For data, you can use import-export. Import from the on-premise, export into the Azure database. Simple thing. Okay, so let's see. Some are tools are available to migrate the database from on-premise to Azure. These are data migration assistant tool. Okay, so earlier we called this one as upgrade advisor. Now we people calling it as a data migration assistant tool. Okay, so this is the tool. Yeah, Microsoft data migration assistant. You can Google it and you can download it from the Microsoft website. This is free tool. Just open this one. So this is a tool. So yeah, see here. So before migration to the Azure, okay, yeah, Azure is you should have some planning. Okay, planning in the sense, why we need to migrate to the Azure, what are the benefits, so how much time it will take, is there any problems will arise both from the database side or application side. These things you need to do. You need to do some analysis. You need to do in pre-production before, okay? Either test environment or dev or UAT. You need to do these things first in the lower environments. If everything is working fine, then you can decide to move into the prod, okay? Without doing anything, moving to the prod means, moving to the Azure directly means, it's not a good idea. Okay, tomorrow if you get any problems after migrating either from the application side or from the database side, it is very, very tough to roll back. That's the reason before doing migration, you need to do some analysis. Yeah. These are the tools available, migration assistant tool. So yeah, to do this one, migration assistant tool, if you want to use, you need to down the application. Once application is down, making down, after that you can migrate using this tool. Once migration is done, application you can connect to the Azure database. Okay. Next, migration assistant service. Okay. We have a service over here in Azure portal itself. Okay. I will show that one. Don't worry. There is a service in the Azure portal itself by using this tool. Okay. Without making database offline or application offline, you can migrate. While application is online itself, you can migrate the database from on-premise to Azure. So there are here only offline is possible. Here offline and plus online is possible. Here we have two options, full load and incremental load within this. Okay, don't worry, I will explain in detail. Okay? Next thing is backpack. Okay, so backpack is nothing but same schema plus data, it will come. Just right click here, take the backpack. So this is the backpack file. You can save into this Azure portal, Azure storage, and you can restore from over here, Azure database. Okay, that way also you can do. And manually also, without a third party tool, you can do manually also. Okay. Normally, we won't do manually, okay, because we have third-party tools, right? Not third-party tools. Microsoft-given tools are there, right, which are free. So we use, obviously, those free tools, okay? So manually, when I go for is, if you are not able to migrate any table or any object, for that one, in the tool, you can ignore that table or object. And remaining thing, whatever left are there, left, those things you can manually migrate. Suppose there is a table employee table, for some reasons, you are not able to migrate. You migrated all the tables, all the process functions, everything, except the employee table. So this employee table, how are you going to migrate? Manually, you can migrate. Just right-click, create table script, and run that create table script in Azure. Next, data. Data, how you can do? Import, export, you can do. Or create a linked server, you can insert the data into the Azure. Okay, yeah, that is one option. And replication. You can use replication also. Okay, from on-premise to Azure database. Just from on-premise, okay. From on-premise to Azure, you can just create a replication. You know, right? Replication only support the tables which have primary key. Okay? So make sure you need to take care. All the tables should have the primary key. If no primary key also, those things you can migrate manually even after. Okay? Just create the replication. Once the data movement is done, everything is done, just break the replication. And Azure database, you can use it for application connection. Okay, this way also. Lot of ways, okay? Whatever we have in on-premise, the high availability disaster techniques, those things you can use to migrate the database. Okay? Suppose log shipping, right? There is 8 terabytes database in on-premise. That database, I want to move it to the same IaaS model. Okay? IaaS model, I want to migrate. Using Logshipping, you can migrate easily. Okay. Here, you don't need much downtime under. Just create a Logshipping between two databases. Okay. Between two databases of on-premise and IaaS model database. Okay. Once the data migration once this is done, just disconnect the application and whatever the last transaction log backup, just take the last transaction backup and copy that backup over IaaS model disk, and there you can restore. And once that restore is done, connect the application to the IIS model database. Simple thing. Okay. So yeah, not only log shipping. Okay. Even you can go for full backup, differential backup, log backup. To migrate the databases from on-premise to IIS model. Yeah, so yes, you may have many doubts on this thing. So yeah, let me explain one by one. So this is a Migration Assistant tool, guys. I am just opening Migration Assistant tool. I am just opening. Here what I am saying is offline. So you required application offline. Because whenever you are doing migrate, if any new data comes, that you cannot migrate, right? So you may lose the data. That's the reason before migration, you need to stop the application. So my best choice is, choice is this one, Migration Assistant Service. Okay? Even without application, without downtime also, you can migrate. Even 4 terabytes, 8 terabytes databases also you can migrate. Okay. Yeah. So let's see data migration assistant tool using how we're gonna migrate and that. So both are same migration assistant tool and migration assistant service. Both are same, but what is the difference is this is you need to download and install. Okay. This is a service available in the Azure portal. But along with this, whatever the feature available, along with this, we also have a incremental load. Using incremental load, you don't need to make the application offline. Okay? No need to confuse here. I will explain you guys. Don't worry. So right now, we are seeing the Migration Assistant tool. So here is a tool. Just click on here. Yeah. Assessment. Here, two things are there, guys. So without just planning, if you are doing any planning, just do the assessment. Assessment is nothing but suppose any database, if you want to migrate, just do the assessment. Whether that database, all the objects, whether you can migrate or not, it will do some test. Okay, it will show some recommendations. If any objects are not able to move, then it will show over here. This object you cannot move because of so and so reason. And next, so use this option. Like that, it will show some recommendations, assessment. Okay. Even if you do migration also, it will show the same thing. But migration is directly moving to the data from on-premise to the Azure. So directly I'm going to the migration, guys. Assessment is not required because this is part of migration. So just clicking migration part. Giving to on-premise to Azure. Something you can give anything. So I want to migrate SQL Server to Azure SQL Database. Or if you want to migrate virtual machine, you can use IIS model. So here it will follow the backup and restore. Okay. Same here it will follow the backup and restore. This tool is not good for these two things. Okay. IIS model database migration and managed instance database migration, this is not good. Okay. For Azure SQL database, yeah, this is fine. So for small databases, you can do with application offline, small databases, you can go with data migration instead. Okay. So for now, I'm doing the Azure database.
See, in Azure, three types of databases are. One is
IIS model DB. Managed instance and single database model. That we call it as a Azure SQL database. So in anywhere, guys, people say Azure SQL database means that is a single database model. Remember that. So don't like crass questions like Azure database means is it IIS DB or a managed instance DB or a single database model, single database DB. No need to question like that. Okay. Azure database is nothing but single database model. Yeah. So here we want to migrate schema and data, right? Yeah. Create.
Sorry, guys. Can you just explain
the
three types again?
Can you talk a little bit loud?
Yeah.
I can't hear.
Raj, sorry, Dilip here. Can you just explain the three types of the migration? Explain it again, please.
So Dilip, I just recorded. So I will share that one again to you. But let me explain you again. Don't worry.
Thanks.
So, not the three types, four types I am talking here. Okay. There are multiple ways. Okay. You can choose either of one option to migrate. Okay. Which option is good for which one? I will explain in each one. Okay. There are like these many types. We don't have that kind of. There are options. Okay, Dilip. So there are options. So this we are discussing about data migration assistant tool. So what I'm saying here, if you want to migrate on-premise to Azure, it has to follow schema script out, data script out. The same thing this tool will do. Okay. Once I go through this one, you will understand. Okay. Just give me a little time. You should understand. So, just a project name I gave over here. So this is the source server name and a Windows authentication. You can give SQL authentication also, no problem. So what I'm doing here, guys, there is an on-premise database, DBA. Okay, this one. I want to migrate it to the Azure database. Azure. So here on-premise, okay? I want to migrate. There is already a database created here, DBA. This is an empty database, okay? Empty database I created. So I'm using what tool? Migration Assistant tool. Migration Assistant tool, MAT. Okay, what it does, just a schema. Schema it will transfer, next data it will transfer. So I give the source database server. See, in this source server database, we have so many databases. Which one you want to migrate? You need to choose one. This one data, one by one only you can do, okay? All the databases you cannot migrate at a time, only one by one. So I want to do this DBA database migration. Click next. Next, target. Target server you need to give. So what is the target server over here? Dev server 1729, right? Let's go here. This is the server name. Just copy it. This is the tool. Just give over here, this is destination, target server, SQL authentication. Azure, @123, See, here we have only active, if you want, you can do Active Directory authentication password also. So SQL server authentication, connect. See here, whatever the target databases, it will show all the, whatever are there in the target server, it will show all the databases. We have only one database, right? So it has been chosen by default. Okay. So I am migrating to this database. Click next. Dilip, You can understand, don't worry. Okay.
Sure, sure, sir.
So as I told guys, source server, target server, objects it is moving, next data it is moving. Okay, anything, any tool, if you want to migrate from on-premise to Azure database, same formula. See, these are the store policies. These are the tables. So whatever the objects you cannot migrate, then it will show as this. This is a migration blocker. Okay, you cannot migrate this stored procedure because this stored procedure contains the cross queries. This DBA deadlock graph, it contains the see, if I click as soon as here, see it is showing reference to object MSDB database. So here deadlock graph. So I use ASP underscore send email. So there are some cross queries are there. That's why you cannot able to move. So that's the reason. Just unselect it. Okay. Just you need to remove the cross queries, guys. Okay. Before migration. For Azure database. Not for managed instance. Not for ISDB. Yeah. So users not required, guys. Users logins and all. You need to take care before itself, before migration. Okay. So we won't migrate the users because in on-premise we follow login and user process. But here, direct user with password process we will go. So I just removed this one, guys. Next, generate SQL script. See all the script out. You can also do right click and generate script like this. So deploy schema means it will run this schema into the Azure database. So schema is done. Next, migrate the data. So these are the tables. Data will be available in only tables, right? So that's why it is showing tables. So there are very large tables, guys. I am just removing those because it will take a lot of time. Data 10,000 rows, right? Let it be. This one you can do. So here let's connect to the Azure database also. let's take accounts table. Okay, 3 rows are there, right? So we already migrated this schema. So in this Azure database, no data yet transfer, right? Let's run this. See, everything is migrated, no warnings, no fail. This is the source database, target database. Okay. Nothing is in progress, all is done. So now check the data over here as your data. See, the data has been transferred. So migration is very simple, right? Using this migration extension. But the only thing is, you need to make application offline. Okay. Whenever you are doing migrations, right, you need to make offline. So, why you need to make offline is, so whatever you are doing, whatever data insertion updation is happened, right, that new data has not been moved otherwise. So any doubts, guys, you can ask me. So yeah, in this tool. Dilip?
So it is not a recommended process for migration.
It is recommended, very much recommended. So if it is not recommended, then they won't give this tool, right? So
that's correct, but it will be downtime. It will be,
yeah, obviously. So this is flexible, right? This is flexible, and for assessment, you can do using this tool. Okay, no other tool. We don't have any other tool for assessment purpose. Assessment purpose also you can use. So yeah.
Okay.
So upgrade also, if you want to upgrade lower version to higher version, you need to take the downtime, right? So here also, you can take the downtime and you can migrate. So some of the applications, it's very tough to take the downtime, right? Those things you can go for the option data migration assistant service. There is another tool. It's not a tool. It's a service available in the Azure portal. Okay, you can use this one. Even this guy is also saying, you know, let me show you. Oh, migration. I think you can do. I'm creating a new migration. Somewhere it shows you can use. use database migration service instead of this migration assistant tool. Like that, somewhere it will show in this tool. I don't know. Let's see here. Yeah. So this is a this tool. Go back. Select source. So I showed you on-premise to Azure database, right? You can also do go back. Let's create new project. Some project name. So Azure to manage instance or virtual machine. Okay. If you click on this. See what here they are saying. Use Azure database migration service for performing schema and data migrations to Azure SQL management. So here they are recommending using this one. Let's see the IIS virtual machine. Yeah, for virtual machine you can use this this tool. Okay, so both are from same Microsoft products only, right? For manager instance, you can use migration service. So for IIS model, it is a little bit different. Okay, instead of schema script out, okay, you need to do is specify target, right? Yeah, target server we have to mention here. Here add databases, select logins. So how it will migrate here is just it will take the it will ask the backup location and it will restore. Okay, this one. So for backup and restore process, if you are going from on-premise to IIS model, then this is not the good option. Okay, the good option is you can go for LogCP. Okay, so this tool is if you are okay to take the application offline for some time for small databases, this tool is good enough. Even some companies. Some projects Saturday Sunday they have full downtime, right? In that case, you can go to migrate the databases from on-premise to Azure. So I am saying without downtime, right? Without downtime, we have another one migration assistant service, but this would cost. You know, they will charge some amount because just you are using this service. If you don't want to that charges and all, if you are okay with application offline, you can go with migration assistant. So migration assistant service, I will show you now. So any doubts, guys?
Here I don't understand when you say online, because when we do migration, we have to stop the application, right? Since we are moving the database from the source to the target, so correct. No application should be connected correct. To the source. So what correct. Do you mean by online?
Very good question. Very good question. So here, okay, Microsoft is saying is application online, right? Yes, you definitely need a downtime. When you need downtime is, suppose you are migrating 8 terabytes database, okay, for transferring the data, so the application will be online, okay. So in that sense, they are saying to change the application connection string. Yes, you definitely need a downtime. Okay, this is same. I confused while reading in the Microsoft documentation. I read inside. Yes, it required 100%. It required downtime. When at the time of changing the connection stream. So just a couple of seconds, right? Instead of on-premise server name, there you need to give the Azure server name.
They say the application is keep inserting data into the source. So when will then the migration end? If it's like we are, it's a bit confusing because the source is like where the application is currently connected to, right?
Yes.
So if the application is inserting data continuously, and if you are like migrating, when will the migration end?
Yes, correct. Okay. So how they are doing is, any guesses from your side? So suppose you are some architect, working from Microsoft. So if you want to achieve this thing, still application is inserting continuously, still you want to migrate that data as well. Okay, so as an architect, how are you going to implement the solution for that? Any guesses? Just idea I'm asking.
I think first you take the full backup and migrate, and then you keep taking transactional or incremental backup, and then at some point you terminate the connection with the current the on-prem, and then connect it to the Azure.
Yeah, that is IaaS model, right? IaaS model, yes, you can use log sipping, full backup, transaction log backup. But Azure database, it won't work, right? Backup restore. This question is for Azure database.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
IaaS model, that's fine. Okay. IaaS model is fine. But what about Azure database? His question is, okay, while application is connected, suppose application is connected, I started migrating, the data, table by table. Okay, I started migrating. So this application is continuously inserting the data. Okay, so how it will work? So-and-so table already migrated, right? So in that table, if already data has been inserted newly, so how the data will be moved? There is some
Maybe it will create an exclusive lock on the tables, whatever the completed as of it.
Okay. Exclusive lock is, so exclusive lock is placed. Then how it will insert the data? Then no online, right? Application, if you are making application online, means what does it mean? It has to work, right? Perfectly, 100%. If you are making the table exclusive lock, it won't work, right?
Yes, but up to completion of the remaining table, which are not yet completed, those tables may be available to the
You can do that way, but that's a bad idea, right? Okay. One, so in application, something is working, something is not working. That's a bad thing. So nobody will support that one. No clients will support, right? If Microsoft give that solution, the clients will support that solution, will agree to that solution. What other solution, guys? Just idea I'm asking. Okay, so suppose one table is migrated. Suppose this is the table, okay? This is the table is already migrated, okay? It knows, the tool knows which data has been migrated and which many rows and all, okay? Suppose this migration assistant tool is continuously inserting, right? So whatever the rows which are not transferring, those records, and whatever the data updated, whatever the deleted, those records, it will maintain that records. Okay, we call it as a incremental. We call it as a incremental load. Okay, here we call it as a full load. Initially, whatever the data will move, that we call it as a full load. Okay, whatever the data inserting newly, that data it will maintain. That data we call it as an incremental load. The tool itself, Okay. So something inside they use some data capture and all some features they will use, and whatever the inserted, whatever the tables migrated, after that, is there any new data that will maintain in the incremental load? Okay. So once the full load is completed, what you need to do is just take the cutover. I mean, just stop the application. Okay. Apply these changes to Azure. Once this is done, connect the application to over here. Full load and incremental load. While application is, okay, while running the full load, you can make the application is online. Once full load is completed, then incremental load available, right? Because while moving to the data, application may insert, delete, update any new data, okay? So that data, it will maintain the incremental load. If you still move the without application offline, you still the incremental load, again it will maintain another incremental load, right? There is no ending. So that's the reason, once full load is completed, stop the application, okay? Just click on the incremental load. Once you click on the incremental load, all the data will be migrated. Then this database 100% will be in sync. Okay, once this incremental load is completed, just connect the application to this database. Got it? So yeah, here Microsoft is saying is while application is online, but that is in the sense of full load. There is a star mark, okay? So just to make the highlight that point, they are saying online. Yes, obviously if you need while changing the database itself also, you need downtime. Without downtime, not possible. Even failover clustering always on. Without downtime, you can use it for always on clustering, right? People will say, yes, obviously you need downtime. Even failover also. Even synchronous commit failover also, you need downtime.
Raj, during this full load, will application users face any performance problem?
Obviously, yes. Obviously means it's not that much, okay? You have to bear that one, that performance. Yeah, that is one time, right? So in that case, what you can do this one in non-business hours or non-peak hours. Okay. Yeah. So data is moving right from here to there. This migration assistant service is moving the data. Obviously, you see some performance. So instead of business hours, you can do it in non-peak hours.
I have a question.
One second. So yeah, Dilip question asked. If you want, okay, if you really performance problem while migrating also, that's okay, you have to bear that. Or else if you want to increase the hardware, you can increase the hardware for that specific time. But that is very tough, right? Increasing the hardware while the migration in progress. Before starting the migration, just give more hardware and you can migrate. But it's not that much easy, to give extra hardware and all. So it's not like Azure. Just increase the service tier and again decrease the service tier. It's not that much flexible in on-premise. Buying the hardware means you have to buy, you have to put the price. Once it's buying, and you are not using in long term, right? Just for that couple of hours, you need that hardware, extra hardware you need. So normally, okay, they don't give any extra hardware and all. Just they will do non-peak hours. So non-peak hours we are doing, right? Rebuild index, update statistics. So you can plan this thing on the month ends or weekends. Yeah. So go ahead. Somebody is asking a question.
My question is about statistics. Are we migrating the statistics as well?
Obviously, everything it will move.
So we don't see anything specifically displayed about that. I mean,
yes, it won't display, right? Statistics are internally. So today may exist, tomorrow may not exist. Those things it won't show. Those are internal things related to tables. Those are internal things. It won't show. If table is moving means inside whatever are there in the table. Inside only those things available, right? Statistics. Statistics, what else? Indexes. All things are inside in the table. So it won't show.
Okay. The other, just two other questions on the logins and also on linked servers. How do we do about the two?
Linked server, it won't work in Azure. Okay. What you can do from on-premise to Azure, you can connect using linked server in on-premise. You cannot create linked server in Azure database.
I think I had the same question yesterday, and so, I may have misunderstood you, but you said linked servers are.
Let me tell you again. Okay. It's a simple thing. Okay. So there are three things in Azure. Okay. IaaS model. IaaS model, right? In IaaS model, whatever the linked server are there. Okay. Just create it again. It will work 100%. Okay. Next, managed instance. Whatever the linked server are there, you can create it again in managed instance. It will work. Okay. But here in on-premise, okay, to Azure. Okay. In Azure, you cannot create linked server. No. What I said is, yes, if you want to connect from any on-premise, if you want to connect, there you can create the linked server. And you can give the Azure database server name over here. And you can connect to this Azure database. What I am saying is, so on-premise, you can create the linked server. But for this Azure database, you cannot here. You cannot create linked server here. There is no option here over here. See, this is Azure database, right? Where is server objects? There is no server objects here. You cannot create linked server. But here, you can create the linked server. But another managed instance, yes, you can create. Another IaaS model server, yes, you can create it. Hope you understand now.
Yeah. What about the logins?
Yeah, logins you can use as it is. So in IaaS model, as it is, you can go. In managed instance, you can go as it is. Okay. I don't call it as these two are Azure. Okay. People will say, but Azure database, Azure means this is the only. So logins, so we don't follow, in real time, we don't follow login process, right, in Azure database. Just create user with password. So that thing, logins and all, the jobs and all, you can do before migration itself. So if you included those things as part of migration, that will take a lot of time, right? You can do in offline as well. So how you upgrade the versions? How you upgrade the versions? Like suppose 2000 to 2014, if you are upgrading, either side by side or in place. So before migration, I mean before upgradation, you can do all these things, right? Creating users, creating linked server, creating the jobs and all, just to save the time. To see the time of upgradation part.
Thank you. Another thing is there anywhere that we can find the checklist for migration?
Checklist means, I can say one thing. So checklist is for specific to their database, their project, right? So suppose I prepared one checklist. Okay. Same thing if you follow, there are chances missing something related to your database. Right? So
I'm just asking if there are some basic templates available from Microsoft or any other.
Microsoft. So no checklist and all, but whatever we know, which feature supported and all, you can make the doc. I mean, you can prepare the checklist. Even I don't have the checklist. So I have maybe on-premise database checklist I have. So to migrate. So in that, you can use that one, the same thing. And whichever the feature not supported, you can give not applicable, something like that. You can follow same on-premise checklist for Azure databases as well. Again, guys. So don't depend completely on checklist. Okay. So checklist is something for the people who don't have like L2, L3, that kind of supports are there, right? So those people, they don't have an idea. So just if you give the checklist, they will follow that one. So for those kind of guys, checklist is needed. So we guys, we need to keep everything in our mind, and we need to follow. Yes, obviously, I know we face the problem. We know clients obviously will ask you checklist under, okay, to make sure nothing will be missed under. So yeah, again, it is specific to project. So we need to maintain that one according to our project. Suppose in our servers, we don't have LinkedIn servers, we don't have database mail, we don't have any job, something in that case, then I don't need those terms in checklist. So that's why. So if you follow, we don't have any generic, it's very tough to find a generic template. Yeah. Any questions, guys? So yeah, next, data migration service, right? So go home. Here you can check the data migration service. Yeah, Azure database migration. Azure database. See guys, Azure database migration service. So just click on add. Just you need to give the resource group, and just you need to give some name, just on-premise to Azure, any name you can give. Yeah, it required some course, okay, just 1 week course. If you want to give just 1 week course, this is a free edition, it is giving only one course. Just review and create. So if I click on review and create, yeah, we need to give network also, it will throw an error. Yeah, it's throwing error, right? Whatever the errors it will throw, it will show the red mark. You have to go here, and the virtual network name, you can give anything. Okay? Yeah, so you want to. So, oh, guys, yeah. this migration service, it will take a lot of time to create. What I did is the same one before of our class, I created migration service, right? This is the one in the morning I have created, okay? So just open this one. So here, yeah, new migration project. Here project name, any name you can give. On-premise to Azure, something you can give. So source type SQL Server, and target type is Azure SQL Database. Again, it is showing three things. Even you can use this tool to migrate on-premise managed instance and Azure databases also. Okay, so my preference is this service, okay? See here, offline data migration and online data migration. Two things it will show. Okay? So, online data migration, it won't work, guys. Yeah, because this free edition, our CPUs and all, it won't work. So I will show you that one. Okay, in the offline data migration, let's see the offline data migration. See, for offline data migration, you can use this option. Okay, install data migration extension. Okay, using this service is extra cost, you know. So instead of that, you can install this one and you can use it for offline data migration. Go for that option. So just see the windows, how it will show prompts, how it will show. See here also, same. Select source, select target databases, and it will move the schema plus data. Same migration assistant tool, how they do, the same way it does. Okay, so yeah, this online. So how online it will show and all, let me show you. I will send you step by step document. Okay, this one. See how it will follow the right load incremental load. I will show you. Just they are selecting the Azure data migration service, source database. So using this migration assistant service, okay, even Oracle MySQL databases also you can migrate. Yeah, here can you see, guys? Here we have. Just maximize. So here full load. Okay, the same formula only they are using for full load. How migration assistant tool it is following, right? Just the tables and they are transferring, and duration it is showing, number of rows, full load. Okay, so no need to down the application while if you are running full load. Okay, once full load all the tables got success. Okay, what you need to do is just take the cutover. Start cutover means you need to click on start cutover and make the application offline. Okay, and next you can run the incremental data sync. Okay, so earlier 14 tables, right? Suppose 16 tables something it is showing. So 16 tables it has been transferred. Next incremental load, so the same tables, whatever newly data inserted, updated, deleted, the same, okay, the same things will be applied in the Azure database as well. See, after the initial full load is completed, that is marked as ready to cut over. When you are ready to complete the database migration, select the start cut over. And once pending changes, if it will show zero, that time you can connect the application to the database. Whenever you are doing cutover, stop all incoming transactions coming to the source database. Wait until all the pending transactions have been applied to the target database. At that time, the pending changes cutover will set to the zero. See, here they are saying stop all the incoming transactions. That means application offline, right? But if you see real documentation, they say application online. It's while application is in online itself, you can migrate the database. Like that, they saw. But they give some star marks. Okay? The star mark is for only for full load, not incremental load. For incremental load, you need application offline. Okay? Then only we can stop incoming connections and whatever the updates happen, right? Newly, those updates will be applied. This won't take that much time, guys. For full load, it will take a lot of time, right? Because of terabytes size data. So incremental load, right? Incremental load, it won't take that much time. In minutes, it will be completed based on the database size and all. So any questions, guys, here? I will send you a video related to this one, okay? Video and document. So here we can only do this one, migration only offline we can do. Even offline also, maybe it cannot connect to the existing database because my database is fully firewall rule. This is a office laptop. So let's see whether we can do or not. Hey. Yeah, Nana. One second, guys. So yeah, this is the database. This is the tool, right? So select source. Yeah, this is the source name under Windows authentication. Fully qualified name. Yeah. Windows authentication. Windows authentication. So KTPolar. So yeah, probably it won't connect to my machine, guys. Yeah, fail to connect. Let's try with SQL authentication. So yeah, guys, I am not able to connect to this server. Okay, the same way offline is the same way it will show. Okay, how the migration service it will show, the same way it will show. First, okay, source and target we need to select, and after that, so yeah, schema it will transfer, and after that data it will be transferred. So I will send you the document and video related to this one. Okay, so any doubts, guys, in this thing? Migration assistant tool and data migration service. So yeah, here data migration service, right? So from on-premise to Azure database. Okay, you can also use transactional replication. Okay, you can also use your transactional replication from on-premise database to Azure database. You can create transactional replication. Okay, once almost data is completed, what you can do, just disconnect the application. Okay, and whatever the transactions, right, in the replication it will show how many commands are left and all. So once those commands will be transferred, what you can do, just connect the application over here. Okay, that way also you can migrate. Okay, there are a lot of ways. Okay, so which is good and all for your application, so you need to thoroughly test.
What replication will not work for Azure database?
Yeah, so on-premise to, yes, Azure database it will work. Transaction replication it will work.
Oh, for Azure?
Huh?
It will work for Azure database?
Yes.
But there's no server objects on Azure. So is there, huh? there's no replication server object on Azure.
Server objects, not possible.
Exactly. So how do you do replication without the replication object on in Azure? How do in you Azure? Monitor it?
In Azure? Sorry, I didn't get you. Server objects? Yeah, server objects, it won't work, right? Linked server and all.
So replication will not work in the database.
Replication, it's not a server objects, right? Within the database,
for replication use linked servers, right?
Primary database, on-premise database, those will be created. Distributor you need to give in the same source server, on-premise.
Okay.
Everything will be created. Linked server
but,
and
all. But what I'm saying is, so basically, what you're saying is the Azure database will be the subscriber, right?
Yes, correct. This publisher, this subscriber.
Okay. So how does the distributor communicate with the Azure database without a link server?
Same distributor in on-premise. Okay, you can give distributor also over here on-premise. It will create distributor.
I know. But between the distributor and the subscriber,
using username and password. Using username and password.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
So, what type of replication?
Transactional replication.
Yeah, but we have like the push and pull, right?
Huh?
Push and pull.
Here only push, not pull. Push, right?
Okay.
Not pull. Everything you need to do from on-premise.
Okay.
One second, guys. Yeah, I'm back, guys. So yeah, what is the question? So yeah, you can also do backpack migration. It's very simple, okay? Instead of using this tool and all, just in on-premise, right-click the database, okay? Tasks, so deploy database to Microsoft Azure database. Directly you can do, okay? Or else you can do this way. Normally people will do this way. So what it does is, it will take the backpack file. Okay, so normally .bak file, it will take the backup, right? So, but here backpack. Backpack is nothing but it contains the schema plus data script data. It will generate the file and it will restore. I mean, we need to restore. We need to restore in Azure database. You can also go for this option. But the problem, this is so faster, okay? This is faster, but the thing is, okay, in the earlier, in the why I'm saying it is faster means in the earlier like migration assistant tool or migration assistant service to migrate from on-premise to Azure, script by script, table by table, row by row, it has to transfer. That obviously will consume some time. But here, just you are taking the backup and you are restoring. So obviously, it would be a bit faster than them. But the thing is, if any objects you are not able to migrate, but everything will be failed. Okay, so using tool, if any object is not supported, remaining things you can migrate. But here you cannot migrate even one object is not able to move. That is a problem because that is a backup, right? That backup contains all the things. All the things, if you are restoring, then only it will success. Otherwise, it will fail. But when you go for this option is, when you thoroughly tested, okay, in test environment, whether that backpack is working, if it is fine in lower environment, the same you can use in production as well to migrate on-premise to Azure. Okay, so we will see this one. So for backpack, right? For backpack, we need storage account. Okay, we need a storage account. So we need storage account for that. Under storage keys importance, online backup and all. We will discuss tomorrow, guys. Okay? If you have any questions, just ask me. Little bit confusion, guys, if you have. So you can follow this document, okay? So it's already in shared location. You can follow this one. So migration assistant tool, yes, this is, it required application downtime, easy to migrate complex databases, assessment we can do before migration, from SQL Server to all DTU models, we can migrate. Below is the image. So migration assistant service, best choice is migration assistant service, because while application is online also, you can do migration. So offline, the same, how migration assistant tool it will work, the same way it does. But online, we have two options, full load and incremental load. Full load, while application online itself, you can do the full load and incremental load. Before running the incremental load, you need to take the cutover. Cutover is nothing but stop the application and do incremental load and connect. Once incremental load is done, then it will show no changes, zero changes. At that time, you can connect the application to the Azure. So no downtime for the application. I can say no downtime, but obviously it required downtime. But document is saying like that, okay? Microsoft document. yeah, but little bit. No, instead of no downtime, you can say little downtime. Okay. So non-SQL server to Azure SQL, okay? Using tool only SQL server, DBMS only you can migrate. But this service, you can also do Oracle. Oracle to SQL, Oracle to MySQL, Oracle to Cosmos DB also you can do. okay, this using this service, data migration service. Another one is backpack. So testing need to be done prior. Easy to migrate. Make sure thoroughly tested with zero errors. If any errors are there, you cannot migrate. Entire thing will be failed. Yeah. These are the differences. Okay. So if no questions, I'm ending the class for today, guys.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right.